is not very challenging. It's 18Ks, it's quite level, but it's beautiful. Up and down, you pass the Grosvenor Wreck, where you see the remnants of salvage attempts, various salvage attempts.
Day two is an interesting day, longer than the first day. We walked through to Waterfall Bluff, which is quite high up. We walked around to a place called Cathedral Rock, which is quite spectacular. From there through down through some quite deep valleys inland.
31 years ago, Andy Dodd started Drifters, and he actually started it because he had the vision of letting people see some parts of the country they would never, unless they were on a tour or something like that. Andy won the tender, and these camps were established in 2006. They started operating October 2006, and they also, the local communities are 25% shareholders. The local communities get their concession or 25% on a monthly basis. The money is basically used for education and health.
Day three was my absolute favorite. It was all on soft grassy knolls, all on contour paths, round with the ocean on your left and the mountain on your right. One or two steep bits, but it's a beautiful part of the road. Back down onto the beach with a bit of scrambling, with a bit of exciting rock climbing and getting down onto the sand to the most beautiful cave, and then we ran along the beach again. The last bit is all along the beach and a little bit of dust road, and then you're home. It was a brilliant leg today.
We've had a fantastic Pondo Drifter event here again in Pondoland, finishing here next to the Port St. John's River at Cremornay. Three fantastic days of trail running, and the competitors really enjoyed it.